music is Vienna's most powerful cultural legacy. Here Haydn, Mozart, and Beethoven, Schubert, Brahms, and Mahler worked, and the classical style was born. And it was here at Habsburg Vienna's moment of destiny, at the eve of World War I, that this legacy was shaken to the core. To his admirers, the composer Arnold Schönberg liberated dissonance. To his detractors, he transformed music into noise. And in 1913, in one of the era's noisiest cultural controversies, Schönberg's composition caused literally a riot in the music hall. While angry members of the audience shouted insults, reporters rushed back to their offices to declare the young composer insane. Today, Vienna has embraced Schönberg forcefully, dedicating a center to him and his musical influence. Christian Meyer is its director.
So Schönberg, in his revolutionary moment, unleashes dissonance, but presumably this created a problem for him as to how to create structure. How does structure come in Arnold Schönberg's work?
Well, around 1908, 1909, Schönberg had no structure. His atonal music, his three-tonal music, is strictly anarchic. He says dissonance is as beautiful as harmony, mm-hmm. and it's a new harmony, mm-hmm. and that's a revolutionary step, that he doesn't seek for a resolution. He just says what he has to say, and then he jumps on to the next thought.